Convergence is a very important phenomena, so we'll talk about convergence today.
Good morning all. Hello. So today we'll talk about what is convergence. So when an object comes near to your eyes, what happens? There is actually three things happening, okay? One is your convergence, one is your accommodation, and third one is your pupillary constriction. So these three things together, this is called near triad. So what is exactly convergence? Okay, see, when an object comes near to your eyes, what happens? There is a temporal retinal image disparity is created. How it is happening? Okay, see, suppose this is my right eye image, this is my left eye image. Okay, so when there is a fusion, so I will see these two images together, right? So when it is coming near towards me, what is happening? There is a cross diplopia and there is a separation of images. So there is a temporal retinal image disparity when the object is coming near towards your eyes. So convergence is nothing but is the inward turning of your eyes together, okay? Inward turning of eyes, and it is a disjointed movement to maintain the bifoveal single vision. So what is bifoveal single vision? See, if there is any stimulus to cause diplopia, we need to see that object single, right? So we need to maintain that fusion. To maintain that fusion, convergence is happening. So this is a disjointed movement. What do we mean disjointed movement? The eyes are moving in the opposite direction. The right eye is moving in this direction, left eye is moving in this direction. So this is practically an inward turning of eyes, right? And it is causing the lines of sight of the two eyes is meeting at a point. This is my right eye line of sight and this is my left eye line of sight meeting at a point over here. So this point I can see it single, right? With the help of convergence. See, this is our right eye, okay? This is my left eye, right? So there is an object of interest over here, right? So the rays of light from the object of interest falls on the right fovea. Rays of light from the object of interest same way falls on the left fovea, right? So these two are called the corresponding retinal points that gives rise to a single fused image, okay? And this is also the primary line of sight of the right eye. This is the primary line of sight of the left eye. These two primary lines of sight meet together to form a complete fused image at this point. So by convergence, that is our aim is to meet these two primary lines of sight at a point. So then this is an object. When the object is coming nearer, okay, towards you, so I have to converge my eyes. The eyeball should converge like this, right? So that the lines of sight of the two eyes, right and left eye, meet at a point. We can have fusion for that. So convergence is basically of two types, okay? One is called your voluntary convergence, that occurs by our own willpower. The second one is called a reflex convergence that all of us have, okay? So what is reflex convergence? So if there is a visual stimulus or any object of interest, the convergence what we exert, that is called your reflex convergence. Voluntary convergence, all of us do not have that ability to voluntarily converge, okay? So reflex convergence is also of three types. One is called your fusional convergence, that is very, very, very important, right? Other one is called the tonic convergence. So what is tonic convergence? That occurs by the inherent muscle tone of our extraocular muscles. And the third one is a proximal convergence. That proximal convergence that increases with the proximity or nearness of an object. So when an object comes nearer, we exert more of proximal convergence. This fusional convergence is very, very important. This is called the positive fusional convergence. The eyes will move in this direction to maintain fusion. So this positive fusional convergence actually maintains the binocular single vision and helps us to have good convergence ability. So, and also helps us to maintain good fusional ability. So the basic problem if we don't have a proper convergence is that, so okay, you sometimes we feel that that when we read, we can't concentrate, right? Sometimes after while reading books, sometimes we feel that I need a break. Sometimes we feel that the words are getting doubled after long hours of reading, right? You get a severe headache or asthenic symptoms. You complain to your parents that, oh, I cannot read, okay? So these are practically the symptoms of convergence insufficiency, okay? So if you don't have a proper convergence, so we need to have a convergence of about around 6 to 7 centimeters in front of our eyes, okay? So that is our near point of convergence, that need to be 6 to 7 centimeters in front of our eyes. So anything beyond that, or if the near point of convergence recedes or goes far away, okay, so we can have a convergence insufficiency. So basically, what are this? This is the poor symptoms. So we need to treat those cases, right? So if you have a convergence insufficiency, if your child complains that, okay, mom, I cannot read after long hours of reading, you need to consult an optometrist, a pediatric optometrist, or a pediatric ophthalmologist who will guide you in the right way. There are some vision therapy exercises which will definitely improve your child's convergence level, okay, and help them to concentrate more on their studies. Thank you.